The evolution of audio technology over the past 20 years is pretty mind-blowing, and Dolby Atmos, as well as Dts X, are prime examples of how far technology has advanced in the past two decades. Dolby Atmos and Dts X are two of the most advanced and popular surround sound formats, but what, and how, exactly do they do whatever it is they do? Well, to put it simply, both add overhead sound effects to our movie or gaming experience in order to deliver surround sound with greater realism than ever before, including the last-gen audio formats such as Dolby Digital and DTS. So, why are overhead sounds so important? Well, the use of overhead sound effects allows to place individual sounds anywhere in a room, essentially creating an encompassing, multi-dimensional sound experience for the movie watcher. A feature that we like to call object-based surround sound technology, a thing that was pure science fiction just a decade ago. So, without going into the deep in technical terms, what's the deal with Dolby Atmos and how exactly does it work? Surprisingly, it's quite simple. Dolby Atmos achieves object-based surround sound by expanding on conventional surround sound systems with the inclusion of a new addition channel, called a height channel. Let's imagine you're watching a movie with a scene where an aircraft is taking off from an airport, and the filmmaker wants the viewer to experience that overhead takeoff sound. Instead of just using limited directional sound from front to rear and left to right, with the use of Dolby Atmos, the filmmaker can actually place the takeoff sound literally right above you. The end result? You'll get to sit back in your chair and enjoy the full sound of an aircraft taking off right above you, which is pretty cool if you think about it. To take advantage of this Dolby Atmos technology, you'll need to actually install overhead speakers, and a lot of them. Even though Dolby states that using two overhead speakers will be enough to get a decent result, some Dolby Atmos systems utilize up to 34 speakers, so you can either go for the conservative approach and install two overhead speakers, or you can literally go Atmos crazy and install multiple overhead speakers in your ceiling. There's a third option to get some of that Dolby Atmos lovin', and is hands down the easiest, cheapest, and cleanest option of them all. That option is getting a Dolby Atmos soundbar. Dolby Atmos soundbars achieve that overhead effect with the use of internal upward firing speakers without the hassle of purchasing, placing, and installing separate speakers all across the room and the ceiling. As far as the best option, well, it is very individual. If you're going for the flawless, perfect Dolby Atmos sound, you'd probably want the full speaker system, but if price, space, and ease of installation are important to you, a Dolby Atmos soundbar is your move. But wait, what about DTS:X? Well, it started as a movie theater feature back in 2015, but shortly after, it began to appear in high-end home theater receivers and made its way into mainstream home audio systems. Much like Dolby Atmos, DTS:X is an object-based surround sound technology that expands on conventional surround sound systems. However, unlike Dolby Atmos, DTS:X has no requirements for additional height channels or requirements for a specific number of speakers in any configuration. Instead, a DTS:X enabled receiver does all the heavy lifting internally via its auto calibration and object-based processor to deliver multi-dimensional sound to the output channel it decides is best, with the use of standard speaker sets and without the need to install any ceiling-mounted speakers. DTS:X also allows users to adjust the volume of voices on a standalone basis. This is a very nifty feature for dialogue-heavy scenes, since they tend to be difficult to hear clearly, especially with sound-rich scenes. Unlike Atmos, which is still quite a novelty, DTS:X is supported by a large number of manufacturers, with many releasing firmware updates for existing AV receivers. So now, the moment you have all been waiting for, the ultimate showdown. Dolby Atmos versus DTS:X. Who will come out on top in a head-to-head battle? Before we move on to the final results, if you have any audio-related questions you'd like us to answer or clarify, drop us a comment below and we'll try to best accommodate as fast as we can. You can also send us a question on Twitter at GearlyReviews by using the hashtag AskGearly. We have a lot more comprehensive tech news, updates, and reviews on this channel, and many coming up soon, so join our ever-expanding family by subscribing and hitting that notification bell. Are you ready for the final showdown? Can you handle the truth? Honestly, you are not likely to notice any difference between mixes with both of these formats. However, we feel that DTS:X is a much more flexible format, meaning that it translates much better to different kinds of layouts, either standard 5.1 or 7.1. Most of all, since DTS:X is free and simpler to mix, the price of DTS:X-enabled hardware should be more competitive on a value-for-money basis. Having said that, right now, it seems that despite it all, Dolby Atmos is the more popular format as far as new movie releases, so you definitely want to have it in your setup. While it's too early to announce somebody is the clear winner in the DTS:X vs Dolby Atmos battle, we aren't really sure that it's even necessary. Unlike the DVD vs Blu-ray battles that had to end in a loss for one side because of the inherent lack of compatibility between the formats, here we may even have a win-win situation on our hands. The truth is that most consumer-grade audio equipment can be compatible with both technologies without any issues, so it'll come down to which one is more widely adopted by the entertainment industry. As of now, we mentioned that though both formats have seemingly received some degree of support from the big Hollywood studios, Dolby Atmos seems to be in the lead, but it'll be interesting to see who comes out on top when the dust finally settles. Well, by then, these sound formats will probably be obsolete. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you guys next time.